So today we will start the unit 3 in LPT 606 that is related to hide and skin. In that, first we will discuss about processing of hide and skin for preparation of leather. In this unit, we will deal about the different aspects of hide and skin, its introductory portion. After that, how we can obtain hide and skin from the animal. And after that, what are the processes and techniques which are required for conversion of hide and skin into leather? So first one, introduction. What is hide and skin? If we talk of hide and skin, the hide and skin will contribute around 4 to 11% of the live animal weight, and hide and skin is most valuable animal byproduct. After hide and skin, the most valuable byproduct is blood. After that, fat. So you have to remember that hide and skin is the most valuable byproduct from slaughterhouse. And this hide and skin will cost around 55 to 60% of the total byproduct value. So it is a great, or it is a more concern for slaughterhouse or farmer. So first, what is skin and what is hide and how it can be differentiated? So skin, if we talk, skin refers to the hides obtained from a smaller animal, and its weight is always less than 13.62 kg after curing. And this skin is obtained from small ruminants like sheep, goat, pig, even from young calf. We are also telling that this is skin. And in comparison to skin, the hide is obtained from fully grown large animal, and this hide is large, thick and heavy, and the weight of hide is more than 13.62 kg after curing. So this is a difference between hide and skin. After that, how we can go for processing of hide and skin? How we can process hide and skin for the preparation of leather? So in leather manufacturing processing, there are actually three processes. First one is preparatory stages. After that, second one is tanning. Third one is crusting. And all the leathers will undergo all the three processes. Okay. And after the sub processing, in last we are applying surface coating for smooth finishing of the leather. And the operations or the processing techniques will vary according to the type of leather produced, according to the species of animal from which we have obtained hide or animal. So we have to take care of the different operations while we are processing. And the leather making process is in general restricted to batch processing. And if we are doing batch processing, surface coating sub-process is added for to make them a continuous processing. Okay, because in batch processing we are not doing the procedure of that coating, surface coating for smooth finishing. But in continuous processing we are following the procedure of coating for enhanced appearance. Okay, so the operation flow chart we will see. The first one is preparation stage. After that, second is tanning stage. Third is crusting. After that, last one is surface coating. That is a last step for smooth finishing of the leather. Okay, so this is processing of hide and skin in short. And processing of hide skin began with obtaining animal skin or hide after slaughtering, before the animal leaves the body. And after that, this procedure is done by the tanner or by obtaining a skin at slaughterhouse, farm or local for fur trader. So this is restricted to the persons or industry which are involved in the processing of leather, for which we are saying the local term, that is tannery, and the persons working there are called as tanner. So skinning, before tanning or before procuring leather, we have to done paying operation. Flaying is a part of dressing operation. What is flaying? Flaying is simply the removal of skin or hide from the animal by skilled workers following a uniform technique or procedure. And this skinning procedure is performed on fish plate, and fish plate is nothing but it is a steel plate having diameter of 20 centimeter, length 120 centimeter, which is 60 centimeter wide. Okay, and during this operation, we have to keep in mind that before slaughtering of the animal, we have to provide ad libitum water to the animal. If we will provide ad libitum water to the animal, the flaying of this operation will be efficient. There will be no defect present on the skin or hide after skinning. So we have to take care of anti-mortem facilities. Okay, and after slaughtering, if we are hosting the animal, it will improve bleeding, and it will improve bleeding, that will thereby improve the quality of hide. So two major operations, two major points we have to keep in mind at the time of slaughter. First one is we have to keep in mind that we have to provide ad libitum water before the slaughter of the animal. Second one, after the slaughtering of the animal, we have to hang the animal on the rail for the efficient bleeding that will enhance the quality of the finished leathers. So how many types of flaying are there? So flaying will vary according to the convention, according to the species. Okay, so first one is knife skinning. Knife skinning is a conventional skinning procedure in which we are using knives, and air driven reciprocating skinning knives are also used nowadays. And second one is hide pulling. Hide pulling is actually used for large ruminants, that is cattle and buffalo, and there is a hide puller. It is an equipment by which we can efficiently remove the hide from the animal. And hide separation procedures in which we are pumping the air into the carcass between skin and muscle, by which the hide is efficiently removed. So we have to keep in mind the types of flaying. So I have told earlier that there are three stages of processing. First one is preparatory stages, second one is tanning, third one is crusting. So first one is preparatory stages. The preparatory stages is started when the hide and skin we have obtained from the animal after slaughtering. And during this preparatory stages, many of the unwanted raw skin components, fat, fascia, muscle are removed. Many options of treatment of the skin exist, but all the procedures or steps cannot be performed. So preparatory stages of skin or hide includes preservation, and the preservation can be performed with the help of curing operation. Curing operation, what it will do? It will remove water from the hide and skin, because hide and skin has lot of moisture, and if we do not remove this water, then the hide and skin will be spoiled and it will not be converted into leather. So we have to maintain the moisture, or we have to remove the moisture efficiently. So what is curing? Curing means curing simply means it is the treatment of hide and skin procured from slaughter animal with the salt, and it is employed to prevent putrefaction of the protein substance, that is collagen, resulting from the bacterial growth during the time lacks from procuring the hide when it is processed. So simply the curing will do? It will remove the moisture, by which the bacteria will not get enough water to divide or multiply. That will reduce the water activity. That is the action of curing. So what I told earlier, that curing removes water from the hide and skin using a difference in osmotic pressure. Why there is difference in osmotic pressure? Because we are using salt component here. What salt will do? Salt will create the osmotic difference between the hide and outer solution. what will happen in that? The water present in hydrogen scheme will go from lower concentration to higher concentration. That's why curing is applicable with the help of osmotic pressure principle. And the master content of hydrogen scheme is generally reduced and the osmotic pressure increased to the point that bacteria are unable to grow. And the concentration of salt is more, by which bacteria will not able to grow in higher salt concentration. So there are two types of curing. That is, first one is dry salting or curing. Third one is wet curing or brine curing. In dry salting or curing, what we are doing after procuring hydrogen skin from the slaughtered animal, what we are doing, we are applying the dry salt over the skin or hide, and we will kept in package for 30 days. During 30 days, what will happen? The moisture will be removed from the hide and skin, and by this their water activity will reduce and no putrefaction procedure will occur. Second one is brine or wet curing. Brine or wet curing is the fastest method of curing in respect to dry salting or curing. In what we are doing, in this method, we are making brine. Brine means solution of salt, and salt solution we are dipping the skin or hide, and we are kept for 16 hours or sometimes even weeks we are also keeping this. During this, what will happen? The moisture will be removed from the hide and skin, and it will go to the solution, by which the water activity of the hide and skin will lower, thereby preventing the putrefaction or spoilage problems. Or another method are common nowadays, what we are doing, they are doing curing, they are doing with the help of keeping untreated or uncured hydrogen skin at low temperature, by which the activity of bacteria will reduce, so the hydrogen skin can be preserved for longer period of time. Okay, this is regarding this. So this is the simple flow chart operation for integrated leather tanning industry. First, we are getting raw leather. Raw leather will go into pre-tanning processes. Pre-tanning procedure will consist of soaking, unhairing, liming, baiting, deliming. After that, second process is tanning. Tanning is of two types, vegetable tanning or chrome tanning. We will learn in detail after this. And after tanning, the last procedure is finishing. Finishing will consist of mechanical operation, finishing, and after that we will get imperishable leather that has a very long shelf life. So we will deal one by one. So after that, the second operation is beam house operation. After curing, what we are doing, between curing and tanning, some procedure we are performing. These are intermediate steps that is known as beam house operation. And beam house operations includes soaking, liming, removal of extraneous tissues with the help of unhairing, scouring, or flashing. After that, we are doing deliming. After that, we are treating with enzymes. That is known as baiting. After that, drenching. And last one is pickling. So we have to remember the different procedures or steps involved in beam house operation, and we have to know that this is an intermediate procedure between curing and tanning. Okay. So what are the different stages, or what are the different steps at the three stages of the tanning operation? First one is preparatory stages. That includes preservation, soaking and liming, unhairing and flashing. After that, splitting and reliming. After that, baiting and degreasing, bleaching and pickling. After that, next stage is tanning. In tanning, we are doing tanning with the help of two methods. First one is vegetable tanning. Second one is mineral tanning, or we can say that is chrome tanning. After that, last stage is crusting and coating. In that, first we are doing baiting or samoying. After the shaving, neutralization, detanning and dyeing, filling, conditioning, and buffing. Buffing means smoothing the leather surface. Okay. So first, one by one, we will see all the steps. So first one is soaking. Soaking is carried out to allow hide and skin to to reabsorb any water which has been lost after flaying in the curing process or during transport. So soaking is a procedure which is performed at the tannery. What the cured leather or hide we had obtained in which moisture has been lost with the help of salt. So we had to recover that moisture for processing into leather. So soaking is the simply recovering of moisture of hide and skin for further processing. What soaking will do? Soaking will clean the hide and skin in which there is a removal of germ, blood, dirt, fascia, and other interfibrillary material so that hide and skin can be further efficiently treated. And the soaking method used depend upon the state of hide, and this process is carried out mostly in two steps. First is a dirt soak to remove the salt and dirt, and the second one is main soaking. In first, what we are doing, by simply washing or by simply running a tap of water, we are removing the dirt or blood, clotted blood which is adhere on the skin or hide. After that, we are performing the main soaking operation, and the duration of soaking can range from several hours to few days. And putrefying bacteria can thrive during soaking, and biocides may be added to curtail their activity or to stop their activity. In next slide, we will see some biocides name. What are the biocides we can use for that removal of putrefying bacteria? So typical soaking procedure, if we see the different temperature, time or residence details condition. So soaking, we will perform it at efficiently at 28 degrees Celsius. The transfer of heat will be, medium will be waters and chemicals, okay. And so during soaking, to remove the bacterial growth or to destroy the bacterial growth, we are using biocides, and the main biocides which we are using, diethiocarbamates are commonly used. After that, we can also use certain fungicides like 2-thiocyanomethylthiobenzothiodiazole is added to destroy the fungus or to prevent from fungus infection or to prevent mold growth. Also, we can use pentachlorophenol and mercury based biocides. Okay, and depending upon the types of raw material being soaked, we can also use certain additives or surfactant or enzyme preparation for efficient that tanning of the leather or hide. Okay, after that, after soaking, we will perform the procedure of liming. After soaking, the hide and skin are taken for liming operation, in which we are treating the skin with milk of lime, that is a calcium carbonate solution which has a pH of 11 to 12, and it will also involve addition of sharpening agent, that is disulfide such as sodium sulfide, cyanide, amine, etc. What liming will do? Liming will increase the pH of the hide and skin which has been soaked. Actually, the soaked hide and skin has the pH of around 7 to 8. But when we will do liming, its pH will be increased. And this increased pH is required for further tanning operations. So what are the objective of this liming? Remove some of the interfibrillary solvent proteins such as mucins, remove the hair and other keratinous material, swell up and split up fibers to the desired extent, remove the natural grease and fat to some extent, bring the collagen in the hide to proper condition for satisfactory tannage. So the last step is the main requirement for liming, in which we are increasing the pH. And what we'll do, collagen will absorb the water, they will swell. Okay, after that. So the interfibrillary proteins are denatured by the presence of alkali, rendered soluble, facilitating their removal from the leather. Failure to remove these proteins results in hard, tiny leather that is brittle and inflexible. And the main protein present in leather is keratin. And if what will happen due to the treatment of alkali, its hydrolysis will take place. Their disulfide bridges will be broken, and it will allow for the further tanning operation. and long time period and long periods of liming will result in hair removal, because this lime has a high pH, so it will work like soda, and so it will remove hair efficiently. And the removal of keratin is performed during unhairing operation. We had learned in that is what intermediate operation, that is Bimhaus operation. And in traditional processing, liming and unhairing are indivisible and take place at same time. Okay. And the presence of calcium hydroxide will result in alkaline swelling of the skin, and this results in influx of water into hard skin and a marked increase in fiber diameter. And this increased thickness or diameter causes the surface area of the pelt to decrease. And due to the increased absorption of water, the weight of the hardened skin will be increased. Okay, and the action of liming in particularly causes swelling of the skin, resulting in splitting of the fiber, bundle sheath present. And this will allow for further tanning operation. And this that breaking of fiber bundle sheath or increased pH, which allows for better tanning, retanning, dyeing, and fat lickering procedures. Okay. So after that procedure, liming, soaking, after that liming will be followed by unhairing and scouting. For unhairing procedure, we are using some unhairing agents, that is sodium sulfide, sodium hydroxide, sodium hydrosulfide, calcium hydrosulfide, dimethylamine, and sodium sulfhydrate. So these are the unhairing agents which will remove the hairs on the skin or hide present, and it is an essential step. And sometimes what we are doing, the majority of the hair which is present after unhairing procedure are removed with the help of knife. With the help of knife, we are removing the skin. This procedure is known as scouting. Okay. So this is known as scouting procedure. After that, next procedure is deliming and baiting. So unhairing or scouting operation is performed by deliming or baiting. Deliming, what purpose for deliming is there? So we have to reduce the pH now for baiting procedure. So the pH of collagen is brought down to the lower level, so the enzymes may act on it. This process is known as deliming. And depending on the end use of leather, hide may be treated with enzyme to soften. There is a process called baiting. Baiting is simple enzymatic treatment of hardened skin. And in what we will do baiting, additional removal of protein material loosened by liming is achieved by enzymatic digestion, the operation of baiting. And in modern tanning operation, these enzymes are purified agents and the process no longer required bacterial fermentation. Two types of main baits are used. First one is pancreatic baits, that is digestive enzymes from pancreatic glands, or bacterial baits, that is digestive enzymes of bacteria. So the deliming procedure will always be followed by baiting. What we are doing deliming, in deliming procedure, we are decreasing the pH. Why we are decreasing the pH? Because enzyme can act efficiently. You are knowing very better that in our stomach, where pancreas enzymes are working, their pH is low. From that point of view, from there we are reciprocating it. Here also we are decreasing the pH to act pancreatic enzyme efficiently. So that is known as deliming or baiting procedure. And if we talk of a detailed method of baiting, in this the hide and skin of lime to are decreased to a pH of 8 to 8.5 from 11 to 12, and this degree of alkalinity at which most enzymes show greatest digestive power. And the goods are then usually treated in 300 to 500% water at 31 degrees Celsius with 1 to 2% addition of powdered enzyme mixture, and we have to maintain the pH and temperature accurately for working of the enzyme efficiently. When slight flattening of the grain or increased flexibility is required, the time of baiting can be shortened, and longer baiting times are necessary for extreme stretch and suppleness. And the digestive action of wetting is start by making the condition unsuitable for enzyme activity by cooling to 60 degrees Celsius or by washing with water. So today I will discuss up to method of wetting only. After that, in next lecture, we will discuss about pickling and tanning operation, crusting, etc. Okay?
Okay.
So if you have any query, you can ask me, huh?
Okay, sir.
Nitish, you are having any problem?
No, sir.
Then you read. Then you read it, huh? I will send you one book, huh? From you that.
Sir, kindly send me all PPTs of face meet and
this
slaughter of the module.
Yeah. I will send you all the PPTs and in next week I will take your quiz also, huh? From face meet also and from slaughterhousing. House by product technology also. Okay. So
okay,
I will then stop lecture now, na?
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, bye. Okay, then bye, huh?
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Okay.